Now here it is the question number 6 of exercise 6.1. Using the given pattern, find the missing number. So again, first you need to find the pattern which is going to be followed, then you will be able to find the missing number. If you are going to follow that pattern, here 1 square 2 plus 2 square plus 2 square equal to 3 square, 2 square plus 3 square plus 6 square equal to 7 square, 3 square plus 4 square plus 12 square equal to 13 square, then 4 square plus 5 square, and here the number is missing. Whose square, that number will be there, that you need to fill, equal to 21 square. Now if you are going to follow the pattern, here 1, 2, 2, 3, 2, 3, 6, 7, then how it is going to be followed? First I am going from the top to the bottom. Here it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. You can find it is going to be followed 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And here it is 2, 3, 4, 5. And here the number is missing 7. So if you are going to follow that pattern, then 2, 3, 4, 5. And what will be here? 6. If you are going to follow the pattern, here what the number you will get? That is 6. And here it is 7. So here you got the number, one number which was missing, you got it. Now what, how you are going to get that number, 2, 6, 12, how you are going to get? Here 1 into 2 equal to 2, 2 into 3 equal to 6, 3 into 4 equal to 12, then 4 into 5 equal to, here it will be 20, 5 into 6 equal to 30, that is given, 6 into 7 equal to 42. So it means, whatever the number is going to be filled here, that is going to be multiplied these two numbers. 1 into 2, 2, 2 into 3, 6, 3 into 4, 12, 4 into 5, 20. So that pattern is going to be followed. Now here, you are going to get 3 square, 7 square, 13 square, 21 square. Whatever the number these are written, 3, 2 plus 1, 3, 6 plus 1, 7, 12 plus 1, 13, 20 plus 1, 21, 30 plus 1, 31, then 42 plus 1, it will be 43. So this number is one more than the number which is written here. You can find that pattern. So here all the numbers are filled here. So students, pattern related question, first you need to go through the questions which the numbers are given, and after that try to find the what the numbers are going to follow that pattern. It is going to be increased or decreased, whatever the pattern will be there, you will get it easily. Now students, here it is the question number 7. It is written that without adding, find the sum. Here it is the simple sum. 1 plus 3 plus 5 plus 7 plus 9. What will be the sum of this? 1 plus 3 plus 5 plus 7 up to 19. What is the sum? So you need to find the sum, but it is given that you are not supposed to find that sum directly. One way is that you will add this and you will get the answer. But without adding, you need to find that what will be the answer. So here whatever the number these are written, first I am going to explain that what type of number these are. 1, 3, 5, 7, 9. These are the odd numbers from 1 to 9. So these are the consecutive odd number starting from 1. So these are the 1, 3, 5, 7, 9. Again 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11, 13, 15, 17, 19. These are the consecutive odd numbers starting from 1. 1, 3, 5, 7. So all the numbers are the sum of odd numbers starting from 1, and these are the consecutive odd numbers. So here I am going to explain that how you will find the sum. Suppose that if I am going to ask 1 plus 3, these are the first two odd numbers, 1 and 3. What will be the sum? 4. How many odd numbers are there? 1, 2. These two numbers are there. So 4 is the square of 2. So 2 square is 4. If I am going to ask 1 plus 3 plus 5, these are the three consecutive odd numbers starting from 1. 1 plus 3 plus 5, 5, 3, 8, 1, 9. 9 is the square of 3. And how many odd numbers are there? 1, 2, 3. Then 3 square is 9. It means if you are going to find the sum of odd numbers, one more example I am going to take. 1 plus 3 plus 5 plus 7. I have written the first 4 odd numbers. These are the first 4 odd numbers. 1, 3, 5, 7. These are the first 4 odd numbers. These are the first 3 odd numbers. These are the first two odd numbers. So 3, 1, 4, 5, 9, 7, 16. It is equal to 4 square. So you can say that sum of first two odd number is 2 square. Sum of first three odd number is 3 square. Sum of first four odd number is 4 square. So you can say that sum of first n odd numbers equal to n square. If I am going to ask that what will be the sum of first 7 odd numbers, so you will say 7 square 49. So here you can find the condition is that should be the first. It should be started from 1. So 1, 3, 5, 7, 9. These are the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 first odd numbers. So what will be the sum of these? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then it will be 5 square equal to 25. You can add it and you will get 25. 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11, 13, 15, 17, 19. These are again the odd numbers and consecutive odd numbers starting from 1. So how many odd numbers are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So what will be the sum of these? 10 square equal to 100. Again, how many odd numbers are here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So it is 12, then 12 square equal to 144. So here, it is the way to find the sum of first n odd numbers. Any odd number is not missing here, and all the here in all these questions numbers is starting from 1. So there you can apply that formula. Here it is the question number 8. Two parts are there. Express 49 as the sum of 7 odd numbers. So you need to express the 49 as the sum of 7 odd numbers. So student, 7 square equal to 49. It means if you are going to write 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus, that should be the odd numbers. 1 plus 3 plus 5 plus 7 plus 9 plus 11 plus 13. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So these are the 7 odd numbers. And what will be the sum of these? These are the 7 consecutive odd numbers starting from 1. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. These are the 7 odd numbers, and their sum will be 7 square n square. So 7 odd numbers are there, so their sum will be 7 square, that is equal to 49. So here 49 is expressed as sum of the 7 odd numbers, that will be equal to 49. 121, 11 odd numbers, so 11 square equal to 121. It means you need to write the first 11 odd numbers, their sum will be 121. So 1 plus 3 plus 5 plus 7 plus 9 plus 11 plus 13 plus 15 plus 17 plus 19. Count that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and here 21. So these are the first 11 consecutive odd numbers. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So these are the first 11 odd numbers. So their sum will be 11 square, that is equal to 121. So it is the complete solution of the question number 8. Now, students, here it is the last question of this exercise 6.1. How many numbers lie between squares of the following numbers? Like if you are going to find the square of 12 and square of 13, 12 square will be 144 and 13 square will be 169. So how many numbers will be there between 144 and 169? That you need to find. In the same way, what is the numbers, how many numbers will be there between 25 square and 26 square? How many numbers will be there 99 and 100 square? So students, in the previous video I had explained that if two consecutive numbers are there, like 12, 13 consecutive number, 25, 26 consecutive number, 99 and 100. So if n and n plus 1 are the numbers, and if I am going to ask that how many numbers will be there between n square and n plus 1 square, I had explained that in the previous video also. So if n and n plus 1 consecutive numbers, so how many numbers will be n there between n square and n plus 1 square? That will be 2n. So here it is n equal to 12, then n plus 1 equal to 13. So how many numbers will be there? So there will be 2 into 12, 2n. So here n is 12 and n plus 1 is 13, equal to 24 numbers lie between squares of 12 and 13. In the same way, 25 and 26, so there will be 2 into, and n is 25, n plus 1 is 26. So 2 into 25, that is 50 numbers lie between squares of 25 and 26. In the same way, 99 and 100. So follow the same. There will be 2 into and 99. That is equal to 198. Numbers lie between squares of 99 and 100. So that is the complete solution of the exercise 6.1. I had explained all the question, so that you need to do in your copy. That is going to be completed. Now thank you, students.